All right, folks. Look what I got. I got me a 10C Evo. See how well that works. And then I got these things. These are my warmer freeze-out glove liners. I figure between these and the heated grips, I should be fine. Tried them on with my gloves to make sure they are not too thick. Fancy. This is downtown Raleigh, kind of, sort of. Well, near. 5 minutes away. That's not too bad. That's not too bad at all. I'm reminded of that angry video I did. If you haven't seen it, look it up. It's called As Embarrassing As It Is Funny. But don't watch it with kids around, because I have a lot of bad language in that video. Don't be opening that video at church. Put it that way. Yeah, that works. I'm hungry. I need some food in my belly. I don't know what to eat, though. All the money I just spent, I should be eating nothing! Nothing but shame! So that 10C Evo hopefully will be a good choice for me. Somebody recently commented on the double wishbone, or I don't know if it's double wishbone, the Hassock suspension on this bike. Talking about how BMW had it, or has it, and the person who owned it, I can't remember your name, sorry, said it was terrifying. The downward forces or whatever. And I gotta say, you know, coming from Harleys, you know, I had a Softail Standard, I had a Road King Classic, I had an Ultra and an Ultra Limited. And on those bikes, on all those bikes, if you, you know, this is your front brake, right? So if you grab a whole handful of that front brake, that front end just dies right down. And especially if you're like in a sensitive parking lot maneuver kind of thing, where you got the handlebars turned all the way over and you slam on the brakes, man, that your bike's going down. Happened to me a few times. I didn't go all the way down most of the time. I caught it, but it was always scary. This bike, two incidents stand out for me. The first one is, God, that was a horrible turn. The first one was, what's this guy doing? Watch it, Chucky. Jesus, he didn't even see me. All right, this guy thinks he's something, right? So let's have a little bit of fun with this guy. Sport mode. This guy next to me here, he's got that can on his exhaust. Bleh, bleh, bleh. Oh, that was fun. Yeah, you ain't never gonna beat a bike. You ain't never gonna beat a bike. Not in that little Fiat. I don't care how fast you think you are. I put him in his place. That is so basic. That is so primitive of me. I should be ashamed. And yet I'm not. You know what? I think I'm gonna go this way. So I get on there, there's a whole lot of food opportunities that I probably shouldn't be partaking in anyway, so. Ah. That was bad, Mike. Come on. Come on. You guys ever do that? Anyway. All right, the incidences. Ready? I didn't forget. I'm here. So the first thing that happened was I was out on the Highland Scenic Highway with Moose 3971 and Harley Trick. And there was this long straight stretch that we had already been down. Had we already been down? Anyway, I looked down it and I saw there was nobody on the road because it's like the Blue Ridge Parkway, only straight. And there's this really long 2 mile stretch, at least 2 mile stretch of nothingness. There's no on ramps, there's no exit ramps. It's kind of up high, so it's not really easy for a deer to jump on. Oh, they could have. And I said to the guys, you know, I'm going to go up to the next turnout, the next overlook. I'm going to go really fast. I want to gun it. Come on, guys, let me gun it. So, all right, fine, go ahead, gun it. And they're laughing, saying, yeah, if we're going to get a ticket, he'll be the guy to get a ticket. We'll be able to go right by. Because we had already gotten pulled over that day. Anyway, so on federal land, too, that would have been like a federal offense. So I gunned it, right? And that thing went real, you know, 112, I think is what the limiter has it at. And when I get to, you know, I'm having a good time, and I look over, and to my right up ahead, really close, is the overlook that I'm supposed to pull into. And here I am doing 100. And I slammed on those brakes, and that bike just went... It just stopped. I have it on video. If you look at my Highland Scenic Highway video, you can actually see how quickly that bike goes from like 100 to nothing. It was really impressive. Totally in control. I don't remember if the anti-lock braking system kicked in or not. I can't remember at this point, but all I know is that bike was so awesome. Going from 100 to nothing, slamming on the brakes as hard as I could. That kicked some serious butt. I think I'll go this way. Maybe they have something I can eat over this way. Oh, that's what I really wanted. I forgot about that. I just realized what I really wanted. I want pizza. I want like New York Italian pizza. I know where to get it too. Nowhere near here though. All right, the second incident happened, it was in, where was it now? I think it was in Michigan. It was over by Munising, Michigan. I was at this hotel with Jay, with Moose. We're on our big trip to the Tetons, and we're in this parking lot, and he was on his Harley at the time. He really mastered how to U-turn that thing in no time flat, right? So he goes into this parking space, and he makes his U-turn within two spaces, and I'm, you know, following him. So I go to do it, and I'm not as good at it as he is, so my target fixated or whatever, I didn't turn enough. And so now I have to kind of inch it. And what I screwed up on was, I should have used the walk feature, walk forward, walk backwards, because my hand was not in the right position. And as I had the handlebars fully over to the, you know, I pulled in, so I was making a left turn. No matter how hard I tried, I kept revving that engine, and it's in drive. So the bike's in drive. There's no clutch to feather. And the bike's lurching forward. I'm grabbing the brake as hard as I can, and I ended up grabbing it as the thing was full lock position over the handlebars, and the bike didn't dive down. It just stopped. That's all. Just stopped. Jay thought for sure I was going to hit him. He was bracing for impact. That's how much it jerked. That's a very dangerous feature of this bike. If you're in, you know, like garage type maneuvers, you know, back and forth. If you twist that handlebar, if you twist that, you know, the throttle while the bike's in drive, if you have an automatic and you can't, you know, neutral clutch it, that could be really, really dangerous. You could smash, and that happened to me at a gas station once too. I almost hit the gas pump. So I always try to be careful to have my hand, you know, low down like that, you know, so that way when I go to reach for the brake, it naturally de-throttles. You know, the thing they teach you, have your hand like this on the throttle. And then when you reach for the brake, you have to go like that, which de-throttles. So I always try to do that, but, you know, you can make a mistake. So if you're going to be doing these delicate maneuvers, like making a really delicate U-turn in a garage or something, and you don't want the bike to even possibly lurch forward, and you can't have the, you don't have the clutch that you can pull in because it's an automatic, just put it in walk mode. And you use little toggly things, and then you can walk it forward, walk it backward. I've been using that a lot lately in my garage because of my three cars now, or my three vehicles in the garage thing. And that has worked out just fine. Just fine, I tell you. Oh, I love these glove liners, baby. Oh man, my hands are toasty, toasty. And I don't have to change gloves because those Held Airstream 2 gloves, They're good for the cold, but they're a pain in the ass to get on. Those long gauntlets pissed me off. I'm just a talking fool today. It's a ride directly into the sun. Look at all these guys clustering up here. I gotta back off of these people. Back us off, Ensign. Nice and slow. There we go. I don't want Niles Crane. Or not Niles Crane. I don't want Fraser Crane on that Enterprise-looking ship blasting through at me. That's a reference for you. Every time I ride in weather like this where it's fall, so the leaves are not on the trees so much, and the sun is coming through, and it's like flashy, 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 flashy. And I'm thinking, I wonder what people do if they have epilepsy. I guess they don't drive. Because you can't drive if you have epilepsy, right? I think I just answered my own question, dummy. I wouldn't want to have an epileptic fit just because the light's glinting through the trees at me. God, wouldn't that suck if you couldn't ride anymore because you have epilepsy? Oh, you couldn't drive. Oh my God, I don't know how people survive that. If you live in a place where there's no buses, what do? I guess you invest in Uber. Maybe I could have some Chinese food. Listen to me. I'm hungry and I'm thinking about everything. Chinese food, I could have Mike's subs. I'm going to Wendy's, I could go to the supermarket. What am I going to do? I don't know. Yeah, I don't really want to go all the way into Fuquay from here. That's at least another 20 minutes just to get a slice of pizza. I don't think I'll do that. I think I'll just go back to school, and on the way I'll figure something out here. See this here? This is tempting, right? See this white line? I could go to the right of this vehicle, and I could go right through and not have to wait this light. But no. That's where all the nails are, all the nails and all the debris. I'm not doing that. No, thank you. Ah, the smell of exhaust fumes at a red light. Damn. Is that right? I guess it changed automatic. I don't remember changing it. It's 51 degrees now. Ooh, heat wave. All right, I'll tell you a story. How about that? I'll tell you a story real quick. My high school graduation. How about that? You want to hear about my high school graduation, 1989? In May of 1989, I graduated from high school. And I was not a popular kid. I know, surprise, right? I was a nerd. I was a geek. I hung out with my girlfriend Monique and my best friend Sean. That was pretty much it. Rodney, I hung out with Rodney a lot, and Claudel and Fred, but that was about it. Everybody else I kind of knew, but I my whole point was to not be there. I went home for lunch. I didn't come back for like three periods. It was great. I hated being in high school. Anyway, so I wasn't the most popular kid. I was a nerd. And as I'm walking across the stage at my high school graduation, it's dead silent. You know, usually there's people clapping and cheering and this and that, but nobody really knows me. Or if they do, they don't really care. You know, I'm a nobody. I'm not A crowd, I'm not B crowd, I'm not C crowd. I wasn't even a headbanger crowd. I was a non-crowd crowd. And all of a sudden, in the silence, you hear someone in the distance in the crowd somewhere yelled out, "Geek!" Right up in the middle of the stage. And I'm wincing like, "Oh, son of a bitch! It was my friend Rodney." Oh, God. And the local cable station had recorded the whole thing. And they kept playing that moment over and over again for like the next 2 months on the local cable station. Geek! Geek! I wish I could find that tape. Oh my God. He forgot that he did it, of course. I met up with him a couple years ago. He was visiting his brother down here. And I reminded him of that. He laughed his ass off. He did not realize he had done that. I got another one for Rodney. I was at my 10-year high school reunion in 1999. And the two of us are standing there talking. I probably mentioned the geek thing to him back then too. And this girl walks up and she was kind of portly back in high school. And she got even more portly, you know, that we knew her at this reunion. So he says, "Hi, it's great to see you. So when is the baby due?" And she gets this really, like, "I'm going to kill you" look on her face. "I'm not pregnant." I'm not joking. He literally jumped up in the air and ran out of the building. And I didn't see him again until 2 years ago. Oh, my God. Oh, what a gaffe. And he didn't remember that either. I reminded him of that. He's like, "God, did I do that?" Like, "Yep, I watched you do it." Oh my goodness, that was so funny. Rodney, what a character. All right, let's see. What am I going to eat? I don't know. I'm going to go over here. Maybe I'll go to Harris Teeter and get me something. I don't know. No pizza for you, Mikey. No pizza for you. You get something else. Maybe I'll get a sprig of celery and just crunch on that for a while. Not likely. I used to love that. Now all I think of is headache. That's all I can think of. Because I've had so many of them. Headaches, I mean, from the bike. Oh, looks like my old car behind me. Cool. Gee, wee Christmas. Look at all these cars. Am I ever going to make a left? Come on now. I think it's time for some rock star parking. Oh, you know what I'll get? I'll get a chicken sandwich. That's what I'll get. I'm gonna get a chicken sandwich. Chicken's not bad for you. Plus, it's got lettuce. Chicken sandwich it is. Do not eat here. Ever. Do not do like Mike.